All right, we are basically entering week two. There were about 4 days of abuse on my part because I left the lights on and my cat's in the way. Left the lights on and I didn't turn the heat on, and it got a little cool around here, so the lettuce weren't doing too well then. But basically, tray 3 and 5 were put in a little later, so they're slightly under 2 weeks. Trays one, two, and four are basically at 2 weeks, maybe in a day. They're starting to get a few more leaves. Some real nice color. I particularly like the color on number 5. And we got 5 different varieties of lettuce here. And let's see if we can get some little picture of the roots here. See some of the roots starting to hang out and everything. They're hanging into the gross solution, the liquid fertilizer. So that's the lettuce. I think the things I would do differently, besides getting my cat to plant them next time for me, is I would take longer on the sprouting process. I had them in the cubes, and just as the roots barely began to pop out, I wanted to put them in here to get them going because I was in a hurry to get started. Probably wait a little longer. The bases of these seem to be awfully skinny, and I don't know if that's a result of that or not. But they're starting to take off. I would expect by week three, if I can keep my cat out of here, they should be growing really nicely. So we'll see. I'll check back in a week. All right, an update on my ruby red Swiss chard. The one on the right has been in there for longer than the one on the left. The one on the left, again, wasn't really rooted out of the bottom, but it had the leaves, so I decided to just put it under light anyway and let it grow. See if that was a mistake or not. So far, it looks like the one on the right's doing well. Can't wait to see what it looks like in another week or two. So that's an update on my ruby red Swiss chard, grown hydroponically using the Kratky method. So update on my bell pepper, same thing. I was impatient and wanting to get it under here, under the light, because I had the green leaf starting to form. We'll see how it goes. So far, it seems to be doing really well. The bell pepper seed took forever to sprout, which may have led to part of my impatience. It was a very slow sprouter, but it looks like it's starting to go. Got it in a 1 liter soda bottle that was cut to size. We'll see if that's a big enough grow medium for it. I expect it to get fairly tall with a pretty good root structure, so it'll be an interesting experiment to see whether this is a enough space for it to grow out of, and whether it gets top heavy and needs to be supported or something. So again, this is a learning experience for me. Don't pretend to understand it beyond just the basics of getting started. So this will be a lot of fun. Anyway, looking forward to seeing the bell pepper grow. All right, here's an update on my Vates Blue Scotch curled kale. I put it into the cube. Again, same thing with the lettuce. I would let it grow longer into the rock wool cube to let it sprout a little more. I figured once it had the leaves, I'd just go ahead and put it in the tray and put it under light, and let the roots grow into the solution as they do. So we'll see how that goes. Next time, like I said, I'd probably let it sprout a little longer, but that's update on the kale. Can't remember exactly when I planted it in there, so I can't give you a date on it, but we're starting to just barely get a little extra growth on there. Now, I will admit it, this is probably my favorite so far. This is a lemon cucumber put into a 2 liter soda bottle. Converted into a Kratky growing method with a little rock wool cube and a container basket. This lemon cucumber seed has sprouted so quickly and grew like mad. I went ahead and put it under the light. It's developed these nice, big, beautiful leaves, and it looks like it's getting a little bit more growth. So I can't wait to see what happens with this one. It's going to be a lot of fun. Same thing with the bell pepper. I'm not sure if it's going to be a wide enough, stable enough base for it, and I also don't know if it's going to be enough root growing space. I believe it will be with the 2 liter, but I can't guarantee that it's going to be, self-supporting. It may need a little bit of extra support to keep it up once this thing starts growing, but it's doing amazing. Can't wait to see it get going. All right, we've got a cat grass that I grew in some soil under the LED grow lights, and my buddy here is busy chewing it down and mowing it down and having a good time. Like I said, you could probably grow these hydroponically, but I can't imagine why you'd want to. So I just took a regular pot, fill it up with some soil, toss the seeds on. I did one of the tubs with the seeds just scattered across the top, and the other one I actually buried it underneath because I wanted to see if there would be any difference in growth. I didn't think there would be, and pretty much the ones that were on top grew just as fine and seeded and sprouted just as well, and then the roots went down. So anyway, point being, if you want to bury them like the package says, go ahead. If not, go ahead and just scatter them and keep them moist, and then they'll grow. I mean, it's a plant, right? Seeds drop off the plant on the ground and then manage to grow on their own. So as usual, humans make things more difficult than they need to be, but the result of some of it is our cats get to enjoy the end result.